I'm done.
Come on, I need
it. I'm going to complete it, but I'm gonna write some notes down. I'm gonna write a few.
All right, well then you do what you gotta do, and then that way, you know, if this get to a point where it's retaliation because I don't want to comply with doing your job, then it becomes a matter. At this point, you said that you're gonna do a level one. Now you say, you know what, I'm gonna leave it at level two because I already done put it out of service.
You're not gonna assist me.
I don't have to. Do you want to assist your coworker do his job?
You're just making this difficult.
No. It ain't making it difficult. You guys are sitting here. Now you're actually belittling my intelligence. You're acting as if I don't know what I'm talking about because you're law enforcement. Right. So you're using the badge.
No. That's nothing to do with it.
Yes, it is.
I've
you're using the badge.
40 years.
All right. And congratulations. And I've been doing this long enough. But
we're out here trying to keep people alive and trying to keep
I'm actually trying to do that in the course of doing my job by driving safe.
You didn't violate any laws of the road.
Exactly.
Right.
All right. So,
you're here because of speeding or you were traveling too fast on a ramp?
You pull me in here to do an inspection.
That is
you want to do your inspection.
That's right.
I will not obstruct you in doing your job.
And you will not assist me either.
But is it lawful for me to assist you?
It's part of the inspection.
Is it part of the inspection for any citizen to help government official to do their job? You guys been law enforcement for a while. You know this. No. Please answer that question.
According to how we're trained in the level one inspection,
is it? Show me. No. I want to show me it specifically. Sir, if you know where it is, then show it to me specifically, please. That's all I ask.
I'll show you the hose. Listen, let's put all the other nonsense aside.
Nonsense. There you go again, something, Officer Torres. Come on.
I'm trying to keep you safe. So
come on.
I'm going to give you a heads up. On things to look for to avoid.
You just won't stop insulting me.
To avoid hurting yourself.
And then here you are, nonsense. You know, oh, you're ridiculous.
A lot of these air hoses, if they're chafing against anything, just keep an eye out.
They're not. They have their spacers,
There is one here. I'm going to show it. This is the time to learn. Come on up here. Climb up. You see the air hose over here that's been chafing up against the differential? You see the difference of color? That means that air hose has been working at itself for quite some time.
Is it leaking?
It's not leaking. It doesn't have to be leaking. If you look at it, it's chafed through the cord, and the cord is frayed. That means it's out of service.
Sir, I think you're being sensational. This is you being retaliatory because I won't assist you in doing your job.
No.
Yes, it is.
No.
And you know what? No, it's not. No, it's not. I'm better picture right now. That right there is only with smudge. I just rubbed it. Oh my God, dude. You sit there. No. You come look now.
No. I have my partner.
I don't trust his word no more than yours.
Why not? He's been federally.
That doesn't mean anything. That doesn't mean you don't have a vindictive attitude at this point because I wouldn't help you. I'm sitting here looking at this old right now.
Discussion, and we've had a few laughs.
I'm sitting right here. You think it's funny?
No.
You think feeding my family is funny?
Remember when you said you want me to drive the truck?
That I'll take the truck in there if that's what you want me to do.
Well, now you're willing to help.
That's my job. My job is to drive the truck. No, you want to inspect it, you inspect it. But this right here, this out of service claim, is null and void. Null and void. I know exactly what I'm looking for, and I see right here that is not a chafe hose. It ain't no chafe. That was just that smudge. Here, you can come look at it again.
You can see the cord, right?
No, you cannot. I'm sitting here looking at it right now. You come look again. You come and look again. I got it documented. You're not going to sit there and blame that on me. Right now, you are being vindictive. Yes, you are. You are being vindictive. Because I wouldn't and as if his word is valid more than yours. Y'all are definitely law enforcement. Law enforcement, listen, you can...
It's chafed through the court.
It is not. I am witnessing it right now, looking at it just like you did, and I do not see any court. None at all. You come and look right now again.
Yeah.
You come and look right now. Look.
Yeah.
None.
Yeah.
None.
Run your finger that like this.
Ah, look. You rubbing your finger and you don't even see anything. You don't see nothing at all. No, you don't. I'm recording it right now. Look. Nope. None at all.
You don't see that. You don't.
None
see
at all. That's why they have rubber bush in there.
You don't see the fray.
No, there's no fray.
You don't see the fray cord.
I'm recording it right now. No matter how much you try to convince yourself, you won't convince me. That is not a frayed hose. No, this, because you said it doesn't mean it's so.
No, I'm gonna document it.
You've been documented as well as I am, but you are false. You're making a false assumption. You're being vindictive at this point because that hose is not frayed. I'm looking at it, okay, feeling it. I'm looking at it and feeling
right,
it.
Right, but it's frayed.
It's not. That's the thing. You can't make it. So what? I shine a light on dollar bills. Don't make it a $100 bill. So you know you can't sit here and conjure up things on your own accord just because you're being vindictive. I wouldn't assist you. You found something.
Before you even got here.
No, you didn't.
Why do you think I picked you?
No, I don't know why you picked me. I don't pick your brain like that. It's not my job to sit here and basically itemize what you think. I don't have the luxury of doing that.
You see the discoloration?
Ain't no discoloration at all. No, it isn't. Nope, none at all.
Pull that away. I want to see it. Get a picture of it.
Yeah, go ahead. None at all. There's no white line. There's no fray at all. That's just a little bit of rub, okay, but nothing that's putting out certain, and it's not leaking. No thread.
It doesn't have to leak.
It doesn't have to leak, but it also doesn't have to show fray. And there's none.
Okay.
It's none at all. Right. Just because you're saying so.
Just get on the other side for me, please. For my safety.
For your safety now, huh?
Well, for my safety. I don't like anybody standing behind me or near me.
Oh, really? Well, then you need to probably, you know, go and quarantine yourself then.
Oh,
you don't want to deal with the public.
No.
You don't want to deal with the public. Then you're in the wrong business, sir. This is ridiculous. If you don't help government do their job, they'll definitely retaliate against you. That is not no fray. You are generating a violation. That is not a violation. You're generating one, Officer Torres. And I can't believe I'm sitting here even having this conversation with you knowing that is not a fray. That is not at all. It's not. You keep rubbing it. Don't make it so. It doesn't make it so.
Well, no. It is frayed.
First of all, you're stressing the line.
Take a picture.
Can you stop? No, I'm videoing this whole thing because at this point, I feel that you are being retaliatory.
Okay.
That line is not frayed. This is why I'm documenting everything. I have to. Because you guys, the integrity matters. And at this point, you guys are sitting here, you got somewhat angry, I should say.
Oh, no.
Oh, because I've been doing this for 40 years. I ain't never encountered somebody like you. You never encountered someone who stood up for the rights. You never encountered someone who actually know what they're doing. Yeah, because you right now about to put me out of service because of your feelings. Not because of legality. It ain't got legality. It ain't got nothing to do with this. This right here is not a violation. I see it plain as day. Plain as day. No matter how many of your eyes look at it, you can't validate each other's claim because there's no claim.
Okay.
There's no claim at all.
The thing is that it's documented.
That is not. I swear, you guys are reaching. That is a reach. That is not even close to frayed. Not at all. Not at all. It's a shame that truck drivers can't even do their job. You pay for you guys to do an inspection, but don't pay for it to get harassed. I really don't want to pay for it to get harassed, but this is the state we're in. This police state, you know, I support you guys in doing your job. I want you to do your job. What I don't want is to be harassed.
No one was harassing
you. Yeah, clearly you had no problem.
I've never encountered in my 20 years here
and right there
driver
as yourself.
Right there. You are
combative since you started.
No, no. I mean, it ain't got to do nothing with being combative. Okay. You didn't want me. You didn't like the fact that I oppose helping you doing your job. I have no obligation in helping you do an investigation nor an inspection. Both of you know I don't have that obligation to do so. Now, I cannot obstruct you into doing that job. That I can't do. I cannot obstruct you from inspecting this truck, and I will not. Go ahead, inspect it. But I will document you going around and touching and feeling stuff, because at this point, trust issues. I don't trust you guys. Like Officer Torres right now, who just basically made a claim, and this is a claim. It's not no validity to it at all. A claim that my line is frayed, and I'm documenting seeing that it's not. You can say my light is out and it be on, but you seeing it being out makes it a violation.
That's why everything is documented. Everything is being filmed.
Yes, absolutely, and that's a good thing. So that's a good thing.
I can't say that.
You're like, doing it now.
No.
You're doing it right now. You're contradicting your own words.
The court is frayed. That's why it's
the out. Court is not frayed. That's the thing. You saying it is and reality saying it isn't doesn't give you the conch blanc authority to put me out of service because of your feelings.
It has nothing to do with my feelings.
Clearly.
It's in the out of service book.
No, clearly it is, because you had a bone to pick with me the minute I did not want to assist you doing your job.
You thought that the only way to put that out is if it's leaked, and it's not.
No, I know a freight line will put you out of service, but that's not a freight line. That's the thing. You are making that up. I sit right there and filmed it. No, it's...
You noticed the scope. All I'm asking you is just, from now on, when it's repaired, after it's repaired, make sure...
No, it is repaired. There's nothing to repair. It's not even out of service. It's functioning. It's functioning. It's fully functioning, and it's legal.
Through the court.
No, it's not. You saying it doesn't make it valid. You have the law behind you.
Out of service.
The book, I'm not disputing. I'm not disputing what's in the book. I'm disputing what you are claiming.
You've been disputing everything since
you haven't even done anything.
You haven't assisted me.
I don't have to legally assist you. Do I? You answer that question. Do I legally have to assist you doing your job? When the police investigate someone, do I have to help them with the investigation? Do I have to help you with the inspection? You won't answer the question because you thinking some quagmire where you feel answering the question will invalidate your job. No, you have a job to do, but what I don't have to do is help you do it. Do your job. Inspect the truck. Turn the lights on. Turn the wipers on, because when I do my PTI, you are not there to help me. I have to do it all by myself. So you can do it by yourself. If I got to do it and it's lawful that I have to do it, then it's lawful you should have to do it. You can't come out here and dictate to me how to do a pre-trip if you ain't willing to do it yourself. And then say, you have to help me do it. I do not have to help you do your job. Not at all. And I know you know that.
I thank you. Thank you for...
Just what?
He's going to finish up his report. You can wait in the vehicle.
At this point, you guys are just... You're being retaliatory. No, I'm not you. You don't, Medina, I'm not even going to incorporate you into this. You interject it and put yourself into this. This is between me and Officer Torres and his feelings about me not accepting, not actually assisting him doing his job. And you, Medina, who officer you want to get involved in this, can't find where it says that the driver, the operator, has to actually assist you in doing the job. I cannot obstruct you in doing the job, but I don't have to assist you. There's no legal bound for me to help you do your job. In fact, that's nationwide. No one has any legal bound to help government officials do their job. And again, Officer Torres is sitting here, being vindictive, clearly agitated because I wouldn't assist him in doing his job.
Get a few laps.
No. No, no, we done it. It was just a faux pas with me saying that I don't have to drive the truck into the bay. I don't think that constitutes a few laughs. We're not friends.
No.
No, we're far from it. You're terrorizing me at this point. Now you're trying to put me out of service because of your feelings. I know what's in the out of service book, and I know what puts me out of service. A cop that is in his feelings because I wouldn't help him do his job. That's what's putting me out of service. Not a violation on the truck. Not a violation on the truck at all. Because you just found a, quote, frayed line, and I'm looking at the line and seeing that it's not frayed. So just because you say it is, doesn't mean it's reality. I know I'm right. And this is why you have been vindictive by making up something to put me out of service.
I think you do want me to say you're right about everything.
No. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And I'll say it because I'm a man of integrity. Huh?
Would you like a supervisor?
I would.
Well, you would.
Absolutely.
You know you can dispute the violations on the inspection.
I'm disputing it right here, right now, and I'll go the next course because clearly it's retaliation. You guys are ridiculous, man. I can't believe y'all just sitting here. Well, Officer Torrey, I'm pointing this back at you because you initiated the inspection, and now you got to the point where you just in your feelings.
I think at this moment, you got your point across and everything.
You don't try to silence me, sir. Don't try to silence me. I got freedom of speech.
Call up the supervisor.
And when he come, I have a conversation with him too. But please don't try to silence me.
For now, I highly suggest that don't go back and forth with the officer because you're repeating the same thing over and over.
And I can't have the freedom of speech. I can actually say that. No, you're not going to silence me. You, Medina, you might want to just step off from now because you're trying to violate my right. You're trying to silence me. You're trying to silence me, and it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. Well, keep the peace by getting in your patrol car and leave.
You can't tell me what to do.
Yeah, you can't tell me what to do, sir.
At a certain point, yes, I can.
At a certain point, but you're not at that point. It's unreasonable for you to tell me to stop talking.
I'm asking you.
You can ask, but I do not have to comply to stop talking.
To please.
No, please doesn't. Please is not.
You already said.
No, if you don't want me to talk to you, then stop talking to me.
You're just repeating the same thing.
I can. I can because it's freedom of speech. It's freedom of speech.
At this point, since you don't want to listen.
I don't have to. You're telling me that you can tell me all day long to just stop talking. You're telling me
that's already been taken, okay?
No, all right, then if the point taken, then yours is taken. You can leave now.
At this point, good. You got a supervisor here.
Won't make things better, I'm sure of it. Yeah, because you guys are vindictive. Officer Torres wants to inspect the truck.
Which he has all right to do.
And I will not obstruct them from doing it.
Okay. So, is there another issue or?
Clearly it is.
Why?
Because he wants me to assist him doing the inspection.
Well, he wants you to assist how?
You ask him.
But you're to operate the
car. I am. I will operate it. I have no problem, but I do not legally have to assist you in doing your job.
You have to assist with the controls.
No, yes, I do not.
Do. Yes, you
absolutely
do.
Absolutely not. Yeah. Okay.
Yes, you do.
All right. So all
right, give me the phone number to your boss. I'll call him right now.
You're talking to him right now.
All right. By law, you are required to submit to the inspection.
And I've submitted.
And operate the control.
No, yes. Absolutely not. I have no obligation.
Pinch him for interfering if he doesn't assist.
No, I'm not interfering. Yes, you can do your job.
You're interfering.
You can do your job. I'm not stopping you from doing your job.
Yes, you are. You are interfering
with him doing
his job.
No, yes. I'm not. He can do his job.
You have to operate the controls.
No. Why do I have to? Do you assist me?
Are you the driver?
Do you assist me doing a pre-trip?
So, ask my question. Are you the driver?
I don't answer questions.
Right, so you're obligated to do
it. I'm not obligated to assist government.
Give me the keys.
They're in the truck.
Go ahead, you operate it.
There you go. There you go.
Go sit on the curb.
No, I'm standing here because I don't trust you. Now I'm thinking sabotage.
All right, Freddie, we're also going to...
No, I'm not. Now, sir, you're stepping in a legal quagmire because I'm not stopping you from doing your job. You're being vindictive. You are being vindictive. As a supervisor, you're being vindictive. Yes, you are, because now you're telling me that you're going to hit me with something because of your feelings. That's what you're doing.
I'm hitting you because of the law.
No, you have no lawful order. What do you find? Put me out of service on something lawful then. Put me out of service on something lawful. That's all I ask.
We have all the right.
Yes, you do. You have the right to inspect the truck.
Law says you cannot interfere.
I will not.
And you are interfering because you are the driver and you're prohibiting to operate.
No, I'm not. You can operate the truck. Do you know how to operate a commercial vehicle?
We're not obligated to. You.
Oh, yes, you are.
No, we're not.
Well, if you're going to inspect the truck, you need to know how to operate it, right?
Sir, you're interfering with me. So go.
Oh, no, I'm documenting everything you're doing, sir. At this point, I'm suspecting sabotage. And I don't trust.
You know what? I'll be right back.
It's clearly tyranny at its finest. People get in their feelings and then they want to put you out of service, compromising a life. This right here is the reason why you have that vehicle, because it came on a truck. And yet you want to harass me for doing my job. And then you get vindictive about it because I wouldn't assist you in doing your job. This clearly, that's all it is. You guys are vindictive. Then I got an officer that wants me to just shut up. Stop talking. I'm not supposed to be civil in this when you guys are actually trying to put me out of business, ruin my CSA score because of your feelings. It ain't because of anything legal. That line is not frayed. I've documented it and I see it. It's frayed because someone's feelings got involved. Then I got a supervisor over here who is co-signing this tyranny. There's no accountability. None at all. You pay buku money and taxes, pay the FMCSA fees. You do all of this for you guys to do your job. But then when it comes down to doing your job, you want the public to actually help you do the job. We're doing enough by paying for you to do the job. What more do you want? Then, sir, why didn't you say that to start with, Torres? You could have said that and eliminated all of this.
I said it.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't. Because if you did, you know what would have happened? You know what would have happened?
You would have helped me?
Absolutely, I would have. Because you were being cordial. You were being professional. No. You came out with... It always starts out. It always starts out small. Then it escalates.
And then I said, could you please turn on your vehicle? You said, I'm not going to do so.
I said, is that a lawful order? I did not say it like that. Just don't put words in my mouth. I said, is that a lawful order? That's what I said. And you would not answer me. And now you got a supervisor here who's putting me out of service.
That is a statute because right here. This is a
person
statute.
Is guilty of interfering with an officer, which I'm not doing.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. I don't care what you say.
Reading. Yes. This is the statute.
Yeah. When an officer, such person obstructs, resists, hinders, or endangers a peace officer, firefighter in performance of such peace officer, firefighter duty. Sir, I gave Officer Torres carte blanche authority to inspect the truck.
by performance of his duty because it is required that you operate.
No, it is not.
Yes,
citizens do not have to help government do their job.
You are driving this. You are responsible
then,
to do it.
When I do my pre-trip, do you assist me?
We're not required to be there.
And I'm not required to help you. I'm not required to help you. It is no law saying that I have to help you do your job. Do what you need to do, and then I'll do what I have to do. You guys, at this point, are just tyrannical. Can't believe I got a supervisor co-signing this. It starts at the top. Then it trickles right down. And again, no accountability at all. None. My officer gets in this feeling because I wouldn't help him do his job. You know, find something, which is basically his feelings finding it. Calls a supervisor over here who clearly is biased. And then basically, and I know the law.
No, you do not.
No, the law.
Argue with you.
Yeah, well, clearly you want to because you wouldn't stop talking. I'm talking and making a point, and you refuse to hear my point. I do not obstruct you doing your job. I will not obstruct you doing your job. You just have to do it, and I do not have to assist doing it.
We're not even going to talk anymore about it, so just go sit down.
Shame in America. This country done going to hell when tyrants just come and harass a working man, shake them down because of their feelings. God forbid you exercise your rights. We're entering into a whole police state here. Officers get upset with you and then they put you out of service, not even caring about the consequences. Impacting someone's family, taking a truck off the road from Commerce. And then I got an officer here, unfortunately, wanted me to just stop talking. Unbelievable. Just shut up and comply, I guess. God forbid you exercise your rights. Minutes of harassment. Having a CDL is pretty much like in a prison sentence. You got these Gestapo who gets in their feelings and clearly want to compromise your way of living because of their feelings. Ain't because of anything put out of service on the truck. Nope. I documented it myself. That line is not frayed. And the officer just clearly couldn't deal with reality. So he needs a alternate reality. One that he made himself and then wants me to live in it. There's this huge push to defund law enforcement, and I don't support it at all. I don't. But my God, boy, do it need some auditing. Then you got the sergeant over here who co-signs this chicanery because of his feelings, thinking that he could just come over here and override and make it so that a reality that's not even close to valid, they want to change the rules as they see fit because of their feelings. No check, no balance here. None. No accountability. None at all. Pay excess amount of money and fees for new vehicles, for equipment, for uniforms, for everything, only for them to come and harass us. Gestapos. And no matter how they go over there and collude and orchestrate what to say and how to say it, it's invalid.